And we're back, people, and welcome to my next commentary for Yu-Gi-Oh! False Found Kingdom. And I just wanted to say sorry because I was doing a lot of stuff lately. As you can already see, I already did a lot of across-up vids for the Soul Calibur 5 because I know everybody's into them. I might make arrangements of getting more cross-up vids of Soul Calibur 5 because that's got a lot of good shit and a lot of good costumes. So that's an A plus for, you know, getting a lot of shit for those costumes. You know, Tekken 6. Yeah, a lot of it's pretty much like the same thing, except that you're not creating a character. And it's basically like the same shit, but except that you're not creating a character, and all the costumes like are not pretty much is what you expected. Same thing goes with Soul Calibur 5, but there's something to tweak that shit with. That's the most thing I like. But anyway, I'm here and to do some commentaries and here to get the shit over with. And I kind of I hadn't forgot about this. Now, let me tell you something. You see these three things over there? Those three things over there are one of these bosses. And you think that you'll be able to defeat a specific boss to get to the next chapter. No. You need to face three of them. But here's the good shit. I can't believe I said that. But here's the good part to that. You can get one of these special type of creatures if you defeat them. So if you defeat them, you get one of these special items or a special card or whatever, like Guy of the First Knight, Summon Skull, whatever. And what the heck am I doing? If you face like all three of them, maybe four, you get one of these special type of cards or items or whatever. And some of them are useful and some of them are not. I'll tell you that right now because I play this shit how many times? Three? And none of them seem to be useful. So, I probably might tell you that in a second if they ever give me something if they gave me something. I mean, if I defeat him, is what I'm saying. So anyway, sorry for the stuttering, it's been a while, you know? But anyway, let's watch, shall we? And here we go. Oh yeah, I have to warn you right now, someone's watching TVs upstairs, and there's no way to lower this volume down, so I'm trying to make it as quiet as I can for it to be perfect and not hear any stuff in the background. But at least y'all sit with the gameplay, I think. That's not good. Well, that was easy. I've been poisoned? Oh, that's good. That's a good one. I get poisoned by a dragon that has zombie breath. Oh, man. I don't know where that's... I don't want to smell that stench. Just keep giving me zombie breath. I don't want to smell your damn stench. And ah, oh, you killed my... You bitch. Die. How dare you kill my... My badass swordsman. He must have passed out, I guess. With all that zombie breast... With all that zombie breath they gave him. Blessed of Moonlight. Never heard of it and probably never seen it. But I might use it on this, on the next commentary though. Really? Well, that was the first? I thought it was gonna take forever to kill these people. Well, alright then. It's, I guess you do have to kill a specific person. Thank you. Did you hear that? I'm not pretty sure you guys heard that, but it was kind of funny though. I don't know if y'all heard that or not, but if it's that loud, then I guess y'all heard it. Oh, look at this. First, Kaiba wants to help me. Now, this is ironic. He wants to help me, and now he wants to kill me. But I think he was doing that for a good reason, and I'll tell you why. And this is like an old game. I'll probably tell you this shit. I think it with this, Alright, now, he's doing this because Mokuba has been captured. And, he wants to destroy Yugi. And... for some what reason, Mokuba's been brainwashed, so he has no choice but to go up against Yugi, the king of game himself. And yeah, damn. So if he doesn't, well, I don't know what they'll do to Mokuba, but